Hi there. Welcome to Phony Learn. This is a quick guide on how to partition your hard disk drive and delete partitions in Windows. Some of you may ask, but why should I partition my drive? Well, there are several reasons. 1. To separate your files from the program's installation location. Think of your disk drive as a house. Why do we have several rooms in one house? And the answer is simple. To keep our things well organized. Reason number 2 is safety for your important files. What will happen if fire starts on one side of a one-roomed house? The entire house will burn to ashes. There are so many reasons to partition your disk drive, but that is not why we are here. We are here to learn how to partition a disk drive and manage the partitions. Before we get into disk partitioning, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell for updates on our future videos. Alright, let's get started. First, access the disk management function on Windows. To do so, click on the search bar and search for disk management. Select, create, and format hard disk partitions. Alternatively, just right-click the start button and select disk management. You will see the list of your partitions in the volume section. Like in my case, I have 2. Now select the partition that you want to partition into 2. I have 2 options to choose, disk C and disk D. You right-click and select shrink volume. Set the shrink amount to the size of the new partition you want. Remember, don't use the maximum available shrink space. Give it at least a 10 GB allowance, and then click on shrink. Wait for Windows to shrink the partition. Do not interrupt. When Windows is done, there will be a new partition with a tag labeled unallocated. Right-click on it and select New Simple Volume. Click on Next. Make sure that Simple Volume size is maximum. Click on Next. Assign the drive to a letter of your choice from the list. Click on Next. Make sure that the file system is NTFS. Change the volume label to the name you want to call your new partition. Check this box to perform quick format, and uncheck it to perform full format. In most cases, quick format is just okay. Click on Next, and then Finish. A new partition will be created, and Windows will detect it right away. You can open this PC, and you will find your new partition ready to store any files you want. This is an independent partition where you can store all your files, and even if you reset or format Windows, this drive will remain intact. Now, let me show you how to delete a partition in Windows. Go back to Disk Management and locate your partition. Right-click and select Delete Volume. Say Yes on the dialog box. You will now remain with the unallocated space once again. You can extend the drive next to it to take up that space. Just right-click and select Extend Volume. Click Next and set the amount of space to the maximum possible size. Click on Next and then Finish. Your partition is now extended back to how it was. Open this PC to confirm that. And that's all about disk partitioning. Please like this video, and don't forget to subscribe and share to help a friend. See you in the next video.